Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. So in today's video we are going to see how you can create a loader in SwiftUI. So here you can see if I click on this button show loader, it will present me this loading. I'm showing this view at the top and also one text at the bottom. Then also we are just changing the color of the background from white to gray, and once I click on this part it will again hide that view and it will change the color to white. So this is what we are going to see in today's video, which is very easy to create. So let's get started and create this. Again, I will create a new project using Xcode beta project. Let's resize this, click app, let's call it as loader demo. Make sure the settings are same, click next, and let's save it on our desktop. So we want to create a loader, so for that I need to create one property at the start which will basically tell whether this loader should animate or not. So for that I will create one property called animate. So let's create that first. State private var, let's call it as animate, and I will set it to false by default. Okay, now inside my this view I'm going to use a vstack. So let's use a vstack. Inside vstack I will create this circle, which is basically for my loader. And instead of what I'll do is, instead of writing here, I will create a new file and I will use this inside my main view. So let's do that first. Here I will say new file, it will be SwiftUI views, let's call it as loader. Then let me just remove this code from here and let's come to loader part here, and we'll say here a vstack. Let me click resume here so that you can see what is happening. Vstack, inside vstack I want to use one circle. Then below this let me use the trim part, which will actually trim this circle. So I will say dot trim from 0 to 0.7. so you can see this is the part of which we want to show the loader. So we don't want the circle to be filled, so for that I will use stroke. So let's say stroke, and in this I will say angular gradient, which has one gradient property, and this gradient I'm going to initialize with init with colors, I will say. And for colors I'm going to pass two colors, first will be dot black and second will be dot white, and this will be center. Okay, then I want to give style also, so for that I will say here after center, let me just remove this part where I don't want to give start and this part, so I can remove this part. And after center I can close this, and here I will say dot style. For style I will say stroke style, and on stroke style like this stroke style, and inside this I have two properties again, line width. Line width say 5, and inside this I have to give one more, that is line cap, I will say dot round. Okay, so that it will round the end parts. Now you can see it's looking better, and you can see gradient is going from black to white. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to set the frame. So let's give the frame. For frame I want to give width and height, and let's say 60 will be okay. So let's pass 60 here and here. Okay, so this is okay for our small loader. Then after this I want to say that it should be rotating, so for that I will give rotate effect, that is rotation effect, and it will go from, let me just use the initializer here, initializer will tell the degrees of rotation, which will go from, I will say, let me just create one property on which it will be depending, means if it is animation is on, then only we want to rotate it. So I will create property at the first state, private var animate, and by default it will be false, but when it will be true then we need to animate it in the 360 degrees. So I will say when it is animating, rotate in 360 degree angle or zero. Okay, now it's fine. Let's put this as it is, and then I will say dot animation I want to give so that it will show like loading. So I'll say dot animation. Inside this I have one more option, animation, and this will take dot linear animation with some duration, let's say duration of 0.7, and also I want to say that it should be repeating, so I will say repeat forever. And inside this I want to say auto reverse to be false. Okay, now we have created this view. Below this also I want to just save the text, so let me just reduce this, and I want to add text. Our text is nothing but saying that loading, so I will say loading, and let's give some modifiers on this like font weight of bold and some padding, let's say from top I want to give only 10. Okay, so this is our loader view. Also what we can do is below this I want to give some modifications on this. Let me just click resume here so that you can see it here. Okay, somehow it's not actually loading. Yeah, now it's working. Now what I want to do is I want to give some padding to my view so that you can see when I present this it is in white color and it has some spacing or padding at the side, some corner radius also. Let's give that to our this V stack. So first I will say dot padding from all the side, let's say 20. Then below this I want to give the background color, so background will be color dot black, or first we want to give white, and then we can gray color we can give to the main view. Below this I want to give corner radius, so let's give that corner radius, let's say corner radius of 15. And then below this I want to say when this is appeared, means when this alert or you can say loader is available on the screen, so then we want to say the toggle the animate property, means it will start animating once it is appeared on the screen. So for that I have added this. So now let's come back to our main screen and use this loader here. So first of all I want to say here not animate, I will say show loader property. Okay, now I can use the loader here. For that what I will do is I will first create a Z stack so that we can show one view on top of other view, means our loader view on top of this main content view. So for that Z stack, on Z stack we want to create a button. This button again have action and label. For action I want to just say that show the loader, so show loader dot toggle, I will say toggle will change the value from false to true, and if I tap again then again from true to false, basically it converts the value from false to true and true to false. Then for this text I want to say show loader, and then below this I will say if this is true, that is if show loader is true, then present the loader from our loader view, that is loader view I have written here. Now if you can see, if I check this much part, let me just run on the actual simulator to see. Not this one, this is the one which we have already run last time. We are going to run it on the iPhone SE. Okay, until it is loading, I can tell you the next thing what we want to do is we want to set the frame for our main view, which is this, where we want to set the color background to black with some opacity so that it will look different from our loader view's color. And also we want to say that when we tap on that view, our loader should get hide. So two things we want to do. So let's do that until it's loading here. Actually, it's taking too much of time. Let me just close this and run this part again. And until it is loading, we can write the code for our this actual body and this Z stack. So let's frame the Z stack. So let me just add the frame. For frame, I will say here, not the width, I will say max width will be dot infinity. Then for height also I want to say max height dot infinity, and alignment will be same, so we don't want to change that. Then below this I want to give background color also, so let's give background with some color, not here. Color will be black with some opacity. Let's give the opacity of 0.2. And then here I want to say that not directly a black color. First I want to see, check whether the loader is on. If the loader is shown on the screen, then the background will be this black. Otherwise I want to say it will be dot complete white. Okay, then the last one more thing is we want to ignore the edges, and the final part is on appear. So whenever the appear the screen, we want to toggle the value of the loader. So let's say show loader dot toggle so that it will hide the loader. So now let's run it again. Okay, so the last part is working, and you can see if I click here it is not getting hide. So let's run it now, and now it will work because we have added this toggle also, and some color changes will also work. So let me just check one more thing here. We have added the toggle on tap, and we have, okay, so our mistake was that I have written here on appear, but we want to do this on tap gesture. So let me just update this to on tap gesture, and now let's run it again. Hopefully this will work this time. Okay, so now we can see our button, and once I tap on this, we can see our loader is working fine, and if I tap anywhere else it will hide that. So this is how you can create this loader in SwiftUI. I hope you guys have liked this video and you have learned something new. So to get the code from the today's video, you can hit to this my GitHub page where I will upload the video code. And also if you want to follow me, you can follow me on Instagram where I post my daily updates for the videos. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you have learned something new. Bye.